at the screen again.
Sir, okay, sir.
So now you see recording is going on, na? Screen?
Ajay? Yes, sir.
Recording, sir. Is going on. Screen is visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll start with the topic, which is very important. Tool layout and CAM design for automats. So we'll just try to see that also. How do you design the CAM? But mostly CAM design for automats is only giving sometimes rarely. But tooling layout is very important, and this is very important in automats. So we'll be asking with examples. So just taken a thing from the particular one of the sets I have. So tool layout. So what is tool layout in machining operation? The tool layout is a predetermined plan that depends upon the quantity of pieces. So how many pieces, how many work pieces you want to manufacture in that particular shift or in that particular day, in that particular week. So you have to plan your layout, just like the plant layout you might be studying in the industrial engineering, where do you have to place the machines in a machine shop. So you might have seen our machine shop, how we place the machines at particular locations. Like that, in the tooling layout, we have to place the tools in the hexagonal turret of a turret lathe or a capsule lathe. So that is very important. How efficiently you place the tools is very important, because it will provide greater accuracy. So because if there is greater accuracy, the cost will be less. The cost will be, you can afford to give the customer at an affordable price or an economical price. So the accuracy is very important. Because you have to plan your tools properly, just like process planning, the layout, what are the particular tools you have to place in a particular work station, or you can say tool station of a hexagonal turret, of a six station hexagonal turret or a octagonal turret or a disc turret. So that is very important. So this accuracy will depend upon the nature of job. So what is the design requirement? So what is the design requirement? What is the condition of the raw material? Whether it's in a soft condition or a hardened condition, and the shape and size of the raw material, and the number of pieces to be manufactured. So that is very important. So you have to draw the particular, just like a drawing, the plan of a particular building you want to construct. The scale out of the tool is prepared by tracing paper. Well, previously they used to use this tracing paper, but now with the AutoCAD and with the different softwares for 3D modeling like ProE and CATIA, and Unigraphics also, we'll be using for different piping design, for especially in the thermal plants and the nuclear plants. But you can, for this particular scale out, AutoCAD, it's sufficient. So AutoCAD, any version of AutoCAD is sufficient. So you have to, whenever you are drawing the tool out, you have to superimpose. You have to place the particular machine capacity chart. So what is machine capacity chart? On every machine, a particular chart is there. What is the capacity of the machine? How many work pieces it can manufacture in a, as per the particular requirement? So machine, everything will be there apart from the specifications where the machine capacities are. So just like that, just like the seating capacity of a particular cinema hall, or the seating capacity of a aeroplane or a bus or a cargo or a ship. So like that, we have the machine capacity. So a perfect layout, you have to have a perfect layout, because it will eliminate the unnecessary precautionary measures. So you have to take by the skilled operator or the semi-skilled operator. So because without a perfect layout, it eats away, or it will have, we'll have the, we'll lose the machining time, because it's very important. Machining time is very important, because we have to produce an n number of pieces in a particular shift. You cannot produce that. And that productivity also will be affected due to that. So the tool layout for automatic turret lathe is shown in the figure. We'll just try to see that also. But here, we'll just try to see the figure, and we have to follow the steps. So what are the sequence of operations as far as the different the particular turrets are concerned? So at the last, you have to use the parting tool to separate the particular piece from the lengthier workpiece or the raw stock, which is of 1,000 mm or 1 meter, or for different depends upon the particular machine you are using. Already I told you, in multi-spindle bar type, you try to use the lengthier bar stock, but in the chucking type, you don't try to have the overhang, just like an overhang beam in a strength of materials. So you try to have a smaller length. So depending upon that, you try to choose the particular machine in a multi-spindle automatic lathe, and you just try to have the diagram. If the diagram is not there, I'll try to show you in this one. So this is okay. We'll just try to discuss this in the previous pages also. But before that, so what are the various rules that you have to frame? I'll come back to that particular diagram in the previous pages we have. So in this particular, you may ask in the examination, what are the various rules that you have to follow while laying out the sequence of operations, especially for a turret lathe? Already we have seen the turret lathe, the capsule lathe also, but what are the various rules that I have to frame while laying out the sequence of operations? Because that is very important. You don't try to go for the eighth operation before the sixth operation like that. And these are the particular points that you have to bear in mind, or we have to discuss. So the standard tools should be highly used for small batches of work. Because the standard tools, you know, the turning tool, the facing tool, the drilling tool, the twist drill, the boring tools, the reaming tools, and the taper turning tools, the knurling tools, and whatnot. So suppose you want to have large quantities of work, you have to have the special tools. Special tools are the counter boring tools, the counter shunk tools, the whatever the special operations as per the design, as per the particular drawing you want to have. Because this minimizes the machining time, and it will retain the cutting qualities for larger period. Because you already seen the tool life. The specialized tools, we try to use the carbide tips or the particular the different tool steels or the high speed steels, HSS tools. So they will have the tool can run for a longer period of time, and we can avoid the frequent changing of tools. By avoiding this, we can retain the cutting qualities for a larger period. So all these are related to the unit one also. The tool life, according to the Taylor's tool life equation, Vt power n is equal to C. You try to avoid the tool wear. You can have the tool life for a longer period of time. So you try to avoid the overlap working operations. Overlap working operations, whenever you require, mostly try to avoid, but whenever there is, you try to just plan that overlapping. Just like similar operations, you can try to have simultaneous operations you can have on the particular turret lathe. So already I told you in a particular parallel action and the progressive action. So progressive action you cannot do simultaneously, and in parallel action you can have. So you can plan for that also. Not in every time, but for complex design, not for simple design. Simple designs, you can use the standard tooling. So overlap handling operations with each other, and working operations to be performed. So overlap handling operations means job handling operations, the workpiece handling, because it depends upon the fully automatic and semi-automatic. Because in semi-automatic, the unloading operations have to be performed by the operator itself, but after the parting of tools, after the separation of the, after finishing of all the sequence of operations, you try to use the parting tool and separate the finished job from the lengthier bar stock. So all these are very important steps, rules to be followed while laying out the sequence of operations. So fifth one, arrange the cutting tools. So you have to arrange the cutting tools in the numerical sequence. So actually numerical sequence means, already I told you, T01, T02, T03, T04. In machining center we have. We try to use the automatic tool magazine. In the tool magazine, we can place the numerical, we can place the tools in the numerical sequence. So T01, T02, you have to, while writing the, in the case of the computer numerical control lathe, you have to specify the tool number while going for the tool chain. While going tool chain is M06. M06, you have to go for the M06. M05 is for the spindle speed. You have to specify the spindle speed. So different miscellaneous codes also you try to use along with the G codes, that is the preparatory function codes. So you have to, we have that particular thing in the unit 6. So, but we don't try to discuss much, but only in computer-aided manufacturing, we have that particular topic. We'll try to discuss in 4.1, I think. 4.1, your final year students are having the subject, CAD, CAM, or whatever subject. Some particular universities will have separate CAD, separate CAM, but it depends upon the syllabus. So you have to arrange the cutting tools, and multiple cutting tools are cutting at the same time. So you have to, so whenever you are using the multiple cutting tools, you have to counteract the cutting forces, counterbalance the cutting forces. Because how do you counterbalance the cutting forces? You have to analyze the cutting forces beforehand by using a lathe tool. You have to analyze the cutting tool in the X direction, FX in the Y direction, and the in the Z direction, the particular radial direction and the longitudinal direction. So that you have to analyze like that. So like, by analyzing only, you can counterbalance the cutting forces to a maximum extent. That is very important. You have to use the instrumentation, sufficient instrumentation in the form of a lathe tool dynamometer. You have the experiment in the metal cutting, MC lab, metal manufacturing technology lab. So you have to provide a finish cut with a single tool. Finish cut every time you have to use a single tool, the finishing tool. So you can have the correct dimensions on the workpiece, on the job, and the sufficient surface finish you can obtain, whatever as per the drawing, all that. But if eccentricity is desired, just like constancy, we have eccentricity. Just like the tool offset, eccentricity, you try to provide as per the design. If the design is wanting the eccentricity, you require the eccentricity on the job, so you can have eccentricity. You have to set the eccentricity on the job, just like tool offset. Just like tool offset, you have to go for eccentricity of some 0.1 or 0.2, like that, or according to the diagram, according to the design. So heavier operations. So what are the heavier operations in this lathe? The threading. So where you have to have the rigidity. So where rigidity is concerned, you should not be performed in the earlier stages, because you try to finish the turning operation first, you try to finish the facing operation first, and then you try to come to the threading or the knurling operation. Whatever heavier operations, because I already told you, heavier operations, you try to reduce your spindle speed for 1000 or 1200 RPM, the spindle speed n is equal to 1000 or 1200 RPM, you try to reduce by 50%. So you could try to go for 500 RPM or 600 RPM. That's very important, because in the CNC part programming also, you try to specify the spindle speed because you have to go for the change of the spindle speed M05. There you try to specify S is equal to 500. Along with that, you try to specify the feed rate, the mm per revolution. Along with that, you try to specify the depth of cut in that particular line of the part program, which is known as block, Like you are using some particular symbols in a C program or a Java or C++, you have to write EOB, end of block, in this part program. That we'll try to discuss later in the advanced subjects. So you have to use a center drill for drilling small diameter holes, because that is very important ground rule that has been framed for the turret lathe for the tool layout. So this results because why? Because we have to use, why we have to use a center drill, because it results in a better drill access location. That in the last unit we'll try to discuss about the jigs and fixtures, because we have a jig boring machine. It is an ultimate machine where we have to program the locations of the holes according to the diagram. That is very much better, because there also we have to use if we want to use the CNC jig boring machine, there we have to write the program. But in an ordinary jig boring machine, the location of the hole is very important. The position of the hole is very important. We have to we have a specific symbol in the production drawing, because for the particular runout, axial runout, like the radial runout, in the case of a gear, we have the third dimension, that is the side runout, or the parallelism, or the perpendicularity, like that. We have the positional tolerance. The positional tolerance of the hole is very important. Not only the diameter of the hole, but the position of the hole is very important in order to have the smooth drilling. So you have to use the center drill. So that is very important, because in the design engineering and machine design also, we have one particular chapter based on this one. So holes should be extended in diameter, hole, and finished by the boring tool. How do you enlarge a particular hole? First, you have to have the initial hole by the drilling tool or by the twist drill. Then if you want to enlarge the hole, you have to go for the boring tool. Suppose you want to have finish the final size, you have to use a reamer. You have to use the reaming tool. So drilling, boring, reaming should be in a form. But suppose you want to have a stepped hole, not a through hole. Suppose the hole diameter is not a tenemum diameter throughout. Suppose you have a tenemum diameter up to a particular length, and another 8mm diameter or 9mm diameter. Suppose you want to go for a stepped hole in drilling, small size hole should be drilled first. Small size hole means, suppose you small size hole, we have given an example. First 8mm hole has to be drilled first, and then the large size hole has to be drilled after. It may be 9mm or 10mm. That's very important. So you just try to have this. I'll try to share this PPT after the class. Or the PDF after the class. So the counter surfaces, the complex surfaces, not simple surfaces, have to be obtained in two cuts, have to be obtained in two passes. Yesterday we have seen in the particular problems, not a single pass. Sometimes we have to go for a multi-pass, for the finished turning, or the for the machining time. You have to go for, in the case of the multi-point cutting tool. In the multi-point cutting tool, already I told you how to go for the L, the length of the tool have to be traversed. So length of the tool has to be traversed as small L plus L1 plus L2. Like that, for complex surfaces can be obtained by the multi-pass machining, rather than in a single cut. Because you have to obtain that particular the complex shape in the form of a parabola, like the engineering curves, because we have the particular interpolation, the straight line interpolation, linear interpolation in CNC, or a circular interpolation in CNC. So like that, we'll try to go for the G code, G01 for linear interpolation, G02 for circular interpolation clockwise, G03 for circular interpolation, the anti-clockwise or counterclockwise. Like that, we'll try to have the different interpolations, because we have to use the machine control unit and CNC. We try to use that in the CNC trainer lathe, or the CNC, not trainer, but production machine, CNC, the computer numerical control machining center, or a computer numerical control turning center, or a turret lathe, CNC turret lathe. So all these are very important concepts you have to follow. So we'll go back and see that examples also. Where we have missed the diagrams, we'll definitely cover. But some of the, just, okay, the tool layout he has given here. just try to see. I thought the diagram was missing somewhere. So this is a tool layout for turret automatics. So first you plan what, so you just try to see how the particular planning is there. So you try to keep the feed bar stock here, then you have to go for the center drill, then you have to go for 0.99. So you just try to come back to this diagram and finish the 5mm drill, cone drill, and last the remark, and then use the parting off tool or the partition tool to remove the finished workpiece from the lengthier bar stock. And here is a chuck which is holding the job, and this is a form tool to get this form, to get this particular shape. Already I told you form tools are made in the tool room, and some of the form tools cannot be made in the tool room. You have to try to just order from the tool manufacturer. So we'll come back to this diagram again. So what you are doing, you have to feed the particular job to the bar stop one and clamp. I'll try to show you the different numbering is given in the hexagonal turret or the octagonal turret. So we have to feed, what are the various operations to be performed we are discussing now. We have to feed the bar to the bar stop one and clamp it in the chuck. So next one, what you have to use, you have to center end, you have to go for centering of the bar, and you have to have a dwell period. Like in CAMS, we have the particular dwell period, or in the design of CAMS or in some of the particular thing, we have to use that particular dwell period in some of the design of the CAM profiles. So you have to index the turret, or like tool indexing, you have to index the turret according to the sequence of operations. The turret 1, the turret 2, turret 3, turret 4, turret 5, turret 6, in of hexagonal turret. So according to the sequence, suppose you are not doing the turret indexing, like the gear indexing, you will have a confusion. What is the tool you have to use in that particular turret? What is the tool? For a general design or a simple design, we have to use the standard tools. But if you have to use the specialized tools, you have to will be having some confusion. So you have to just have some particular respirator to clean up the index turret. Why we have to clean up? Because previously some operations might have been taken on this particular tool station. Why I'm preferring tool station, because it is the station where we are placing a number of tools for that particular operation. And before going for the machining operation, you have to index turret indexing is also very important, because it is a very important thing, like a tool offset in the while starting the machining operation on a CNC machining center or a turning center, you have to go for the tool offset. What is the tool offset in the X axis? What is the tool axis in the Z axis? The Y axis is not there in the turning operations on the lathe, because X is the diameter, Z is the setting length. X is 20 or 15, that are X in this space. Suppose you try to take this third point, turn 12 mm, X 12, up to how much length you have to turn. Suppose it is 5 mm or 4 mm or 6 mm, you have to specify that in the case of the part programming, X call Z minus 6 or Z minus 8. And after that, you have to use the drilling tool. After that, you have to go for change of the tool. Yeah, that is, you have to drill for a diameter of 9.9. So another turret you have to use, like your second one. And the third one, drill, you have to drill up to 5 diameter hole. So that is as per the design, as per the drawing. After that, you have to cone bottom up to 9.9 mm hole. So as per the design, whether you want to have a through hole, or whether you have to have a stepped hole, or whether you have to have a cone bottom, just you try to see why you are using the cone. It is in the form of a cone. We'll just try to see there in the diagram. After that, you have to finish the particular 9.9 mm, because it is an internal diameter. Don't think, because if it is an external diameter, what happens? External diameter oversize, you can rework. But for the internal diameter, undersize or oversize, you cannot go for rework. Only for undersize of the internal diameter hole, you can finish it off, because 0.1 mm, 0.100 microns are still there in this hole. So you try to use a reamer and try to go for 10 mm diameter and cone. And you try to use that particular shape of the tool in the form of a reamer. After that, after finishing all these operations, what you try to do? You try to use the parting tool and cut off both the cross slide. So this particular diagram is showing seven operations. All this seven operations is showing in this particular diagram. So the diagram is very important. You try to draw the diagram. After that, you try to use that particular whatever 7 points we have discussed. So this is a particular tool layout for the turret automatics, for the automatic lathes. For the automatic lathes, that is the turret lathe. So this is very important. You have to draw specifically this particular job, the chuck axis, the job axis, and this is the parting tool, this is the form tool, and you have to start with the feeding of this particular, the first one, feeding of the bar to the bar stock. And the second one, center drill. That center drill you have to use. Center drill, already I told you why we have to go for center drill. So because it will hold the job for the subsequent drilling operation. Holding of the job is firm in the chuck. So, and 9.9 mm drill. So suppose you want to turn the particular diameter according to the particular diagram, you have to use the turning tool. Then the drilling, then 5.5 mm drill. Then the degrees cone drill. You have a cone drill specifically made in the tool room, or you can procure from the tool room, tool manufacturer. The VDA companies, so different companies are there in Chennai and Bangalore. You can procure for them. So VDA tools are famous. So after that, you go try to go for the 10 mm, 10 diameter for the reaming tool or the reamer. So this is a tool layout, simple diagram. Only you have to draw that particular hexagon form or the octagon form, and then try to draw the axis and try to place the particular the tool stations at the six sides 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that, and start from the numerical sequence of placing the tools in that particular turret. And before what is the primary rule? You have to follow ground rule. You have to go for turret indexing, just like tool indexing, or just like gear indexing, or just like the machine setting. In the case of a CNC machining center or the turning center, you have to go for the tool offset. What is the tool offset you have to make in the X axis or the Y or the Z axis? You have to prior to the starting of the machining cycle, you have, or the cutting cycle or the turning cycle, you have to go for the machine setting. Just like the general purpose machine, the machine setting is very important in the CNC lathes, CNC turret lathe or the CNC machining center. So, and we don't go to the hardware part now, or don't go to the control system part now. We can discuss at full length in that particular subject. So all these are very important. So next we'll try to finish off this, whatever simple example is there. If we cannot complete, no problem. We can take half the time tomorrow and start the introduction of the third unit, if it is possible. So like that. So I'm not in a hurry, but I want you people to understand better. This is a particular, the tooling schedule chart we'll try to discuss after taking one of already we have seen the particular how to make a specialized job in the previous example, how to make the hexagonal bores and a capsule lathe, we'll try to see here. So here in this particular example, we can just see how to make an hexagonal bolt of 15 mm dia from an hexagonal bar stock on a capstan lathe. There we have taken the turret lathe. So we'll just try to finish. So tooling layout, you try to place, practice this particular diagram for the making of the hexagonal head balls. So you have to feed the stop bar against stop one. This is the stop one. And what you have to do, you have to go for rough turning of the ball diameter. So what is the hexagonal ball diameter is 15 mm. So you have to go for the roller steady box. So we have in the tool holding devices, we have discussed this roller steady box type already in the work holding devices and the tool holding devices, the lathe accessories. We have finished. You just try to refer to that particular diagram. So you have to go for rough turning of this ball diameter with this particular roller steady box, tool number two. This is tool number two. So after that, what you have to do, after rough turning, naturally the finished turning of the ball diameter with this particular roller steady box, tool three. So that is tool three. So after that, what you have to do, because you have to make an hexagonal bolt from a hexagonal bar stock on a capsule lathe, you have to cut the threads with this is a self-opening die head number four. You know what you have to use for the dies and the taps. So external threads and the internal threads. So that is very important, taps and dies. And you have to cut the threads with a self-opening die head, which is there on the turret floor. So you have to place this particular things in an order, in the numerical sequence, as per the diagram, as per the requirement. So that is very important. Then you have to face and form. First you have to face and form in the fifth one. This is the facing. You have to face and form, turn the head by tools mounted on the front tool post in the case of a capstan lathe. That is in the turret number five. Turret number five. This is the turret number five. So first you have to face and then form, not the opposite. So you have to, by experience, you have to know by just seeing the diagram, you can see, because all the operators are either semi-skilled or the skilled operators so you don't have to have the fully skilled operator. Semi-skilled is enough, because it is not a numerically controlled machine. You don't have to learn the part programming there, only if it is a numerical control capsule lathe or the turret lathe. So what is the sixth one? You have to separate this one. Already a bolt has been made, hexagonal bolt has been made from the lengthier bar stock. You have to use the parting off tool, which is held in the ray tool post. So why we are using two tool posts, one in the front and one at the rear, you can understand by this particular example of the hexagonal head bolt. So you try to see the operations at 4 and 5. What are the operations at 4 and 5 can be done simultaneously, because there is no obstruction of the tools. Because you have to see, how do you know the obstruction of the tools? In the case of the numerical control machine, you can see on the CRT screen. You can see on the screen whether there is any obstruction. And because how do you know? You have to go for simulation. Before commencing the actual machining operation, you can try to see the simulation on the CRT screen. And if there is obstruction, you have to give a time lag between the different turrets. So here the operations are similar, because what is the fourth operation? You are cutting off threads with a self-opening die. And what is the fifth one you are trying to do? The second, you have to face and form the threads. So there is no obstruction of the tools. If there is no obstruction, the machining time is saved and the productivity can be increased. You can make a number of hexagonal bores like this one. So this is a simple example of the tooling layout for making the hexagonal bores. Sometimes it is asking specifically and sometimes it is asking generally. So if it is asking generally, you are at advantage. But if it is asking specifically, you practice this particular diagram. So you by drawing this two concentric circles and having all the whatever turrets you want for the particular hexagonal turret, you have to make all this one. So all these are very important. Suppose this is there, another one can be placed here, another one can be placed here, according to your requirement. So we will try to go to the another example, because examples, we can by citing the examples, we can better understand the tooling layout. So in this particular example, we can have the bushes. So we can have the bush. How to make a bush from a linear bar stock by, and how you plan the tool layout for this, you have to write the procedure. You have to draw the diagram. How do you machine the bushes from the bar stock? You have to have that particular tooling. What are the particular tooling you have to have? So this is a bush of a particular nature. So just try to see how a bush can be made from a bar stock, from a bar. And you just try to see this particular diagram. So how to produce the bush from a bar stock? So round bar, you try to use a, so depending upon the final shape, you try to use a round bar. A round bar here is loaded on the bar feeder, This is a bar feeder. So just a bar feeding mechanism is also very important. You just try to see in this particular PDF itself, the bar feeder, the bar feeding mechanism. And here you try to load that particular round bar on the bar feeder, the one, and pass through the collet chuck. Collets, why you are using the collet chuck for the hollow pieces, for the hollow cross sections. So you try to use a collet instead of a mandrel. So just try to use a collet chuck. Collet chuck we already discussed in the particular lathe accessories. So here what you try to do, you feed the bar against top one. So length of the bar is fed against the stock, So you see that several bushes can be produced from it. Several bushes, one after the other, without disturbing the machine setting, because for each and every bush, if you are doing the machine setting, you cannot get the number of bushes you want to manufacture in a particular hour, in a particular shift, or in a particular day. So be careful that the length of the bar does not project too much. So I already told you, if you are projecting too much, the length of the bar, there will be overhang. There may be some chance of the vibrations. So you should not, the projected length should not be much. So that is very important. So turn the outside diameter. The second one, you turn the outer diameter of the bar. So whatever particular size that is given in the drawing of the bush with the tool number two, because it is holding the tool number two in this one. So next what you do, already I told you, after turning, you have to go for the drilling, center drill. Drill at the end of the bar. At the end of the bar, you have to drill this one. So drill at the end of the bar for center. So you just go for centering with the tool number three. Here you have to use the turret three. So with the help of the tool number three. Then what you have to do, so drill through the bar. So drill throughout the length of the bar, slightly more than the length of the projected bar. So you have to use that, the twist drill or the drilling tool at the fourth operation, So you have to the length, you just have to see, slightly more than the length of the projecting bar. So that is by, you have, because the operators for operating this machine are more skillful than the ordinary center lathe and engine lathe machine operators or the machinists. So after that, what you have to do, you have to bore the hole with tool number five. Because after the drilling, boring operation. After that, the sixth operation. Sixth operation is the reaming the hole. So you have to use the reaming tool. Like that, you plan your operations. If you want to go for a particular example of a bush, machining of a bush or an hexagonal bolt. So this only you have to practice this particular diagrams. And after that, after finishing off, you have to face A, because the bush, you have to go for facing operation with the tool seven. This is the facing tool. With the tool seven, you have to have. So what is the tool eight? Tool eight at the rear side, at the rear tool poles, you have the parting off tool. You have to part as many number of bushes you have made that is possible from the projecting length of the bar. From the 1 meter bar or a 3 meter bar or a 5 meter bar, according to the particular how many number of bushes you can make in a thousand. Like you try to plan like that using the tool number eight, which is placed in the rear tool post of the capsule lathe. Rear tool post, facing tool is in the front tool post. front tool post. So all this are very important, because for the auxiliary operations, for the secondary operations, already one of you might have asked there. So just for a spare or for the secondary operations, you can use the tool post. And for the main operations or the primary operations, like this one, in a case of a bush or an hexagonal bolt, you can place the tools in the particular turret. And before resuming the machining operation for a bush, you go for turret indexing. You have to place the turret, exact turret, in front of the bar stock. The turret 1, turret 2, turret 3, turret 4, turret 5, turret 6. All these are very important. The rules that have to be followed, or the guidelines that have to be followed. Don't think manufacturing is so easy, because whatever it is, like we are eating at a dining table, the rice, it is the hard work of the farmer. Just like this, the bush or the hexagonal work is the hard work of the machinist or the operator. So it is the two examples. That's why I've given earlier, prior to the theory. Theory also we have discussed. First, what we have discussed first, what is the tool layout, what is the importance in this automats or the automatic lathes. So you have to give a suitable example there. And we have finished the rules that have to be followed while going for the sequencing of the tool layout for the different operations in a turret lathe or different operations in a capsule lathe. All these are very important. And the previous topic, we just try to see. So what is the topic here? The proper planning. Proper planning is required for this particular tool layout. Already I told you, proper planning for the sequence of operations, for the systematic operations to be carried out on the turret and capsule lathe. You have to do in advance. Just if you want to plan properly a particular function or a particular workshop or a particular short-term turning program or any workshop, whether it's faculty or student, you have to plan in advance, like the technical fest or whatever it is. So the following procedures you have to adopt. You have to see, just try to see these points. So you have to first go through the, already I told you, you have to go through the machine capacity chart of the machine. So on which the machining work is to be conducted. So it gives, what is the machine capacity chart will give the details regarding, already I told you, size of the machine, capacity of the machine, how many number of jobs it can just give you in an hour. Because just like while eating, you cannot eat more than your stomach capacity. Just like that, machine capacity, number of speeds, what is the different differential speeds. Because already I already told you, you have to change the speed for the, you have to lessen the speed for the knurling operation, threading operation, heavy duty operations. So feed mechanisms, the differential feed. So all these are very important. Availability of tools. What is the availability of tools there in that particular turret, or the hexagonal turret? All that are there. Collet types. Because collet types are very important for the hollow jobs and the solid jobs, and collets are holding of the jobs we try to have. And the sizes, what are the different sizes of the collets, whether it's a 10mm collet or a 12mm collet or a 14mm collet or whatever it is. So attachments, what are the different attachments? Already we have seen the lathe accessories. So all these are, so you have to have the copy of the drawings. Because drawings, without the drawings, you cannot manufacture a particular hexagonal bolt or a bush. You have to have the specifications of the product also. So all that are very much required for the machining, for the machinist. So you have to go for this proper selection of the proper tools, and the tooling arrangement has to be made proper according to the numerical sequence. And you have to invoke the tool. In computer-aided manufacturing, you have to say it is invoking of the tool, just like you are invoking the God's blessings on a particular day, on a particular day. So like that, you have to invoke that particular tool and call the tool in front of the job for that particular operation. So that is very important. Selection of proper tools is a very important aspect for getting the final shape and size and the surface finish. That is very important. For example, standard tools, already I told you, we have to use for a smaller number of product, whereas for mass production, you have to use a larger number of, for larger number of products, you have to use for the specialized tools, So that you try to make in your tool room, both the standard tools and the specialized tools beforehand in the tool room or in the store storage from the particular storage room. So with the help of the drawing, the product has to be made exactly as per the drawing. You have to make the product or else the customer will not accept the quality control. Not only the customer, there are quality control people, quality assurance people in the department, in the machine shop and the manufacturing shop. They will reject out outright because they won't don't want to compromise on the quality. The production people will try to make as many as products, but they also try to see the quality, but the machinist may not be able to recognize the loosening of the tool, the tool wear, or the, you want to finish off the production in a lesser number of time, you will increase the speed and feed. There will be tool marks, there will be scratch marks and whatnot on the final job, on the bush or the hexagonal bolt, or the there may be the dimensional variation. Not only the dimensions, already I told you that particular other dimensions are there for the particular like parallelism. The geometric tolerance is also very important. The parallelism, the concentricity. We want to have a concentric job, you are making an eccentric job, they will reject. Suppose you want an eccentric job, you're making a concentric job, they will reject. Suppose there is no perpendicularity or squareness in the job, they will reject. There's no parallelism in the job, they will reject. There's no runout, the axial runout in the axial direction or the radial runout, they will reject. There are different things, roundness, each and a position, just the position of a particular hole, they will reject. The drill size, the hole size may be correct, the hole shape may be correct, but if the position is not there, it will not match with the other component. That this particular hole which you have manufactured, the position of that pole, the positional tolerance, so they will reject, the quality control people. That's why it's very important, the production people have to make the machine setting correctly, the particular thing, or the job setting. For example, length of tool travel is also very important. Over travel of the tool is not recommended in CNC part programming because they will give an error in the program itself, because when you are writing the program, the structure of the program and the logic of the program also should be there. Not only the structure of the program, the logic of the program in making the bushes or making the of the hexagonal boards should be correct. Or else they will give overall the over length or tool travel over length error. So you have to, instead of writing Z minus 6, you are writing Z minus 8 or Z minus 5, or you are trying to have more length, it will reject, because you have to see as per the drawing, whatever Z in the negative direction, negative means it will be the particular reference person, according to the reference person, you are using the negative value. According to the diameter, you are using X10 or X15 or X20. So the placement is of the tool is very important, and the numerical sequence of tool is very important. So we'll wind up with this D and E points. So proper spindle speeds, time and again, I'm telling, the machining parameters like speed, feed, and depth of cut are very important for various operations. So you don't use the spindle speed same for the turning and threading operation, the same for the facing and turning operation, or the same for the knurling and turning operation. For specialized operations, you try to reduce the spindle speed. There you have to specify in the line of the CNC program or the block of the program. The S word is used for spindle, F word for the feed, and depth of cut D. And you have to use another constant K. K depends upon the material you are using for the job. So that is very important. So you can use a number of constants for K1, K2, K3, one for material, one for tool, and another for, so you can study this in the adaptive control system and computer aided manufacturing, because it will adapt to the particular cutting conditions according to the material or according to the particular atmosphere, adaptive control system. Just like you're using an AC in summer, but you don't use AC in winter. In foreign countries, they try to use some particular heating devices. So all that you have to see. So work and the tools are then set at proper locations. So the feed trips are there, the bar stops are there, the mechanical bar stops are there, and we have that lead that whatever the we have, where the particular the hexagonal turret should stop before the job. All these are the particular things are there. So all these are the things we have. We can see in a CNC turret lathe or a CNC capsule lathe. So we'll wind up with that. And Ajad, we'll wind up. Ajad, okay. Thank you for patience. Sure. Ajad, you share sure. The attendance. Okay, we'll leave. Thank you.
Wait, sir.